Hey everybody, welcome back to Shed Talks. We've got another topic for you. And today I'm going to steal a line from a Stephen Stills song. It's called Love the One You're With. And what I'm actually going to talk about is this weird incessant need for certain businesses to keep expanding before supporting the existing businesses that are open. So it seems like a pretty common topic, a pretty easy one to talk about, but you'd be surprised. You know, we're in the training business and we talk to a lot of different people along the ways. We've been talking to a customer for a couple of years now, and I'm not gonna tell what the customer name is, but I'm gonna tell a little bit about their story. So for the sake of this story, let's call them a, let's say that they're a pie company and they sell pies, blueberry pies, apple pies, sweet pies, savory pies, any kind of pie you can want. And they sell them by the slice, by the whole pie. You can go there for dinner, whatever you want to do. And the interesting thing about this brand, as we've been talking to them over the years, is every single time we talk to them, they're almost pleading with us saying, hey, we need this. We have got to train our staff. We've got to get on this. But we can't do it now because we're opening a new store. Oh, and then we're going to open another store after that, and then another store. And we actually have 18 stores we're going to open this year. You're going to open up 18 stores and you don't have a training program in place. To me, this seems like just absolute crazy talk, right? I think to most people it would sound like crazy talk. And here's the interesting thing about this brand. I've eaten their food before and it's really good. The quality is there. They've done a really nice job with the food. There's no reason why this brand should struggle, except for the fact that now it becomes really obvious as I've been talking to them. And it's because they don't really have a training program in place. The most insane thing about this group that I've been talking to is we mentioned the fact that they're opening like 18 stores in a year, but I didn't mention the fact that they're also closing stores. How is that possible? How is a store in a business that has a really good quality product and opening stores like crazy also closing stores? Now this to me blows my mind. And I went down and I did some reviews on my own and I actually read the reviews online about why this particular store was struggling, the one that I know had just recently closed. And every single thing that I read points back to a way or a reason that they actually could have solve their problem through training. If they would just invest in their staff, and it doesn't happen overnight. You've got to make a time commitment to training and education. You know, you've got to believe that it's worth your time and effort to train your employees because you understand they're the face of your brand. Especially if you're in the franchising industry and new stores are opening up in new locations, people have an expectation that your store is going to taste just like the other store they went to. They're going to have the same world-class customer experience that they had at your other stores. So it's just ludicrous to me that people don't invest in training their employees, in keeping good staff, and empowering them to solve tricky problems while they're working. So in this example that I'm talking about, this pie shop that we've been talking to has just closed that store that I mentioned, opening up a whole bunch of new stores. They got back on the phone with us and they said, guys, we've got to do this. We've got to do this now. We need a commitment to our team and to our training and to our franchisees because we don't want to leave them hanging. And I could not agree more. And the weird thing is, after about a month of calling them back and forth, they said, oh gosh, guys, we just can't focus on this right now. We've got another store opening now. Now, this to me obviously points back to, well, we haven't even learned how to train the staff that we have. We need to love the ones we're with. That's what we need to work on as a company and invest in those employees so that when people go into each one of these facilities and get a meal, they're not running to the internet to post about how horrific it was or how long something had clearly been sitting out. Or the terrible customer service because the person spent more time looking at their phone than looking me in the eye and taking my order. So it's one of those things where we always talk about, hey, you've got to invest in your people, right? Your people, they are the lifeblood of your business. So go to rating sites and actually read what people are writing about your business. They're going to tell you where you're weakest. And then make a commitment to cover those things and address those things through a culture of training and education and advancement and betterment for your employees. Help empower them. Train your franchisees. Franchisors, make sure your franchisees have tools so when they make their new hires, they got tools to train them and educate them. If you want consistency at all of your locations, they should all be doing things the exact same way. You know, some of them can't throw out the pie after 2 hours and other ones after 6 hours and get the exact same results. These are things that you have to teach them and train them and show them. So focus on your franchisees. Protect your brand. We always say it, I'm saying it again now, an investment in training is better than any marketing dollars spent. There's a great quote, Howard Schultz actually said it. He said that Starbucks is not an advertiser. People think we're a great marketing company, but in fact, we spend very little money on marketing and more money on training our people than advertising. Howard Schultz gets it. I mean, Starbucks, how big of a brand is that? He spends more on training than on advertising or marketing. That's what successful businesses do. They invest in their people, the lifeblood of their businesses. So we're going to leave you with that. Don't forget to love the ones you're with. Tune in next week for more Shed Talks. We appreciate you. Cheers.